and welcome back to my channel. I really hope that you guys can see the quality upgrade because my new camera is here. I'm filming with it right now and the rest of the equipment is also here. So I genuinely hope that you guys like the quality upgrade. That's something that I've been meaning to do for a really long time, and I know it's something that you guys 100% deserve. So here is that. And for today's video, I wanted to do a full glam yet wearable tutorial, and since it's monsoon it gets really gloomy, so I thought let's do a very bright, colorful, fresh makeup, and that is how I came to this look. Now I know it's a little like extra, but since we're home it's a really good time to experiment with your makeup and also brush your skills up a little bit. So yeah, that's the introduction to this makeup look. If you want to know how I got to this, then keep on watching. So I'm starting off with my brows first. I am filling them in really well with this really precise brow pencil. I'm not gonna get into the details of the brows. I think I'm gonna make a separate video for that. But right now my lockdown brows are just like untamable. This is the best I could have done for them. Next, for my eyes, I've already laid a concealer on top of it to make for a good base. And now we're moving on to eyeshadow. So I'm starting with a really nice icy blue eyeshadow and really defining my crease with it. So next I'm adding a green eyeshadow on top of it, but with a more precise eyeshadow blending brush, because I really want a fake crease, like a new crease, and I want it to be like really defined. Also, by mixing the green and the blue, we get a really nice minty green color, which is going to really complement the main color that we're going for today. I'm using the same green under my waterline and then adding the blue on top of it. Now comes the star product, this eyeshadow from Huda Beauty. I love it so much. I use this trick where I look ekdam upar to make sure that that's where my shadow will like spill, if at all. And till that range is where I kind of take my eyeshadow, and then I just put it all over my lid up till my fake crease that I have created, to give the illusion of having bigger eyes than I actually naturally have. But this trick actually works really well for me, and that's why defining the crease in the beginning with the eyeshadow is so important. Also, I have intentionally chosen colors that complement each other, but you can use contrasting colors as well. Now I'm using a white liner underneath my waterline, and I generally don't do this in my makeup looks, but I thought this would complement it really well. Now that we're done with the eyes and the focus is back, I'm sorry, my mother was handling the camera and she is still learning it, so am I. But for the eyeliner, I just went with my current favorite NYX Epic Ink liner, and I have drawn a really thick wing this time. I was really inspired and influenced by like Asha Parekh and Zeenat Aman and all of these old Bollywood heroines and unke katare jo hote the na. So I really wanted to give it a really nice thick wing because the look demands it. Since I have like dragged my crease upwards and the color is so bright and the focus is entirely on your eyes, so I extended the wing like that and then finished it off with mascara. I have then went ahead and put on my fake lashes off camera, and now it's time for foundation. So for foundation and for the rest of my base makeup, I wanted to keep it really simple and minimal, and I wanted it to look a lot more natural, and I really just wanted the focus to be on the eyes. So I'm using the Skin Genius foundation from Nykaa, which kind of gives me more of like a BB cream consistency. This is something that I've said about this product quite a lot of times, and I actually really like the product because of that. Make sure you cover your ears and your neck, and then we follow it up with concealer. So I have just used concealer wherever I thought I needed it. So under my eyes, a little bit on the broken capillaries, the smile lines, all of that stuff. And remember that you really just have to buff in the concealer and the foundation. You do not need to drag it. This is something again that I've mentioned countless number of times, and it's very important, especially if you want your base to look as natural and as flawless as possible. So recently I've really been into like using cream products, especially during this season. So I'm using this eyeshadow pencil from K Beauty as a contour, and
just look at the color of the contour. It's not a stark brown, it's a lot more like red pink toned brown, because I just want the contouring to be there. Like, I want some definition on my face, but I don't want it to be way too snatched or chiseled. Again, I just want the focus to be on my eyes. And you can wear this look with a mask on, like, you don't even have to go for a very crazy base. And I think your eyes will really stand out with this look. It's such a, I don't know, it's such a nod to like a more 90s kind of look, but with a much more 2020 kind of take on it, if you know what I mean. But again, with my contouring, I'm using the same sponge that I used for my base, and now I have some definition on my face. For blush, I am using this Cushion Lip and Cheek Tint. It's meant for your cheeks as well, I think. So I just use a stippling brush and then just add blush onto the sides of my face. And then I set all of the cream products with a wet and dry compact. This is something that I've been using recently and I'm really, really liking it. For my lipstick, I wanted to keep it, again, very minimal and something that matches the look. So I opted for this really nice peachy pink nude lipstick, and it complements the blue really well. So I love the combination of blue and pink, and I think the eyes and the lips do that. All I need to do now is to just finish it off with a highlighter, which is exactly what I'm doing here. I'm using a bigger brush, but I recommend you to use a smaller one. And with that, this is the look completed. I think this is a very wearable look, but I had a lot of fun creating it, and you can literally wear this look with so many things. And that is it for this tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know it's a little like extra and it's a little, I don't know, glam and colorful, but I have made sure that I've kept the rest of my face very neutral, very simple, very minimal. So this is something you can definitely do even on a regular day. I mean, it's just eye makeup. All the focus is on your eyes. The rest is very neutral. And especially now that we're wearing masks, your eyes are on focus. And I have a monolid eye shape, so it's difficult for me to make my eyes look big, but this is one technique that actually works for me. So if you have an eye shape like mine, this would actually work really well for you. Even if you have like similar eye shapes, not exactly monolids, but something similar, this would work for you too. And if you have almond eyes, you're lucky. Anyway, that was it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know what you think about it in the comment section below. And please, please subscribe to my channel. We are so close to 40,000. I cannot even believe it. I did not expect YouTube to be a thing for me. I genuinely did not. But now I have new equipment thanks to YouTube Next Up. And I don't know, I'm just really excited. I'm really pumped to be creating more and more content for you guys. So I want to know what you want to see from me. And if you liked this tutorial and if you want me to do more such fun, creative, medium level, not very easy, but medium level looks. And yeah, I'm going to take your leave now, but I'm going to see you very, very soon. Bye.